Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, I'm going to be passing over to Curtis McHale for Obsidian Monthly. He's going to be rounding up the latest and greatest features in Obsidian that were released in November 2020. He runs a fantastic YouTube channel where he does cover Obsidian, as well as a host of other tools. You can subscribe to him below, as well as check out his Skillshare classes too. You can also check out the Obsidian Made Simple course, which is available to purchase below if you're looking to learn Obsidian from the beginning. Anyway, folks, a huge thank you to Curtis, and on with today's video.
So today we're going to look at the updates in Obsidian this month. Thanks very much, Francesco, for giving me the opportunity to do this monthly with Obsidian. We're going to cover releases 0.9.7 through to 0.9.15 today. The first updates we're going to look at is in our preview mode, where we can toggle our headings. And we can also toggle indented list items now. The other thing you can do now in preview mode is search. So we could look for, let's say, namespaces. Right, and I found namespaces inside my document, which is excellent. Next up, we have some file commands. So we can right click and we can get different commands. We can open a new pane or copy the Obsidian URL. We can reveal the file, open in default app, and show in System Explorer. Another new thing we can do is export a note to PDF. See that right there, and export it. And let's just drop that into my downloads folder. There you go. I have a PDF of the file I just exported. Now to do with the preview mode, there are a couple things in our settings. In our hotkeys, there is now a way to copy the Obsidian URL. So let's search Obsidian. I don't have this bound to anything, but again, if you click this and we could say, I don't know, shift command comma, or shift control comma for me, would copy the Obsidian URL now. So shift control comma. Just copy this Obsidian URL for me. The other thing we can do in our options is we can now toggle whether we want the preview or editor to be our default view. Now let's look at search. One of the new things is it's going to show us our previous searches, the things that we've actually looked at recently. We also have, if we start typing, an X to easily clear our search if we want to do that. For searching to read, it's also going to save our settings for show more context or less context and whether we want the search parameters explained, right? So if I did to read or marriage, it's going to show me text matches either of these two. And it's explained that right here in the search query. While we're looking at this, we'll also note that our backlinks pane, I don't have any backlinks here, so let's go to a note. We'll also remember our settings here, whether we show or hide more information. Obsidian now also accepts a URL scheme. So if we go obsidian:/search?vault, and then you need to equals the name of your vault. So mine is Obsidian. But if there was a word with a space here, I'd need to go %20 because that's a space, it needs to be URL encoded, Obsidian vault. If that's the name of your vault or whatever your vault name is. And then we'll need to do and query. Let's make our query men. You can see it showed up over here. The final big thing that we're going to look at for this is the new third-party plugins. So there's actually a way to turn them on. It has safe mode. We can turn them on. And yes, I'm going to turn on safe mode. And then we can browse. And see, I already have the syntax highlighting plugin installed. Then I can browse my plugins. Come to search, and it takes a few seconds to load, I found. But I know there's a calendar one. So there you go, calendar. So a simple calendar widget for Obsidian. I'll give you a calendar widget up in the top corner if you wanted that. Or sliding panes, right? Explain what they do. Or note refactor. It allows you to yank a little chunk of a note out into a separate note. Then you can install all of these and just click install, right? Update if you want to update it. So they should automatically update for you as well. Or day planner if you want to do that. We can actually do some time blocking in there, which is pretty cool. That's really it. That's the big updates for Obsidian from 0.9.7 to 0.9.15. If you look up here, you notice I'm on 9.16 because I'm on the insider build. So we're just a little bit ahead, which means mostly I might get a few more bugs than you do. Thanks for watching.